disaster. It knows no boundaries. It's impartial. The vengeful spirit of nature, keen on seeking revenge on its oppressors. Look no further than California. Battered with risk of havoc from every possible natural disaster. Fires. Floods. Landslides. And earthquakes, only to struggle with year-long droughts in between. Now these lands bear the scars of man's indifference, yet they tell us a tale of resilience, defiance, and the unyielding force of nature against its battle with climate change. Whiplash, a phenomenon of drastic and rapid swings between extreme weather conditions. Stark changes in the climate start with greenhouse gas emissions, warming up the planet, trapping heat. From severe droughts and fires in one year, to heavy rainfall, mudslides, and flooding the next, these conditions are exemplary to what climate change brings to this world. Extreme weather events.
High in the hills, the city below looks like any other sprawling metropolis. Yet this one is different. Its fame has spread to the four corners of the earth. Its name is known to practically every man, woman, and child in the universe. For this is Fabulous Hollywood.
Decade was just sunny and dry and kind of your typical California weather. In the past year-ish, we've had a lot more rain, and you can see the hillsides are not ready for it because the drought, you lose the vegetation, and it's just all prone for big slides. It's like fire doesn't care. It'll jump over a freeway. It'll be far away 1 minute, and then so quickly it could be in your backyard. I mean, I walk these hills almost every day, and I mean, the number of homes on stilts and just the sheer volume of house after house after house and this teeny tiny roads that we have. I mean, I can't tell you the number of times I'm driving down my street and another car's coming from the other direction, and there's not enough room for us to pass, so somebody has to back up. I mean, I can't imagine what that would look like in a state of panic where everyone's trying to get out. There's probably a lot to be done to get up to where we need to be as the environment continues to do what it's doing.
Rising average surface and water temperatures cause major adverse effects, which lead to extreme conditions like those faced by California and the rest of the United States in the recent past. The El Niño Southern Oscillation, understood as a recurring climate pattern affecting water temperatures in the eastern Pacific, is extremely vulnerable to climate change, and it may cause extreme cold and heat spells to become more frequent and stronger by the end of the century. What does that mean for us? More severe droughts, slower moving and more destructive hurricanes, extinction of keystone species, and the slow collapse of our ecosystems, not just in the United States, but the world. Emissions and overconsumption of resources have drained the lifeblood of our planet and will only lead to more destructive natural disasters more frequently. Since the beginning of 2024, 37 million people were under flood alerts in California alone, about 94% of the state's population. The first week of February saw about half a year's worth of rain in just one day in Los Angeles and the surrounding area. Landslides and flash floods from the storm caused as much as $11 billion worth of damage to the state from one storm. Compared to all of last year's winter storms in California, which caused $4.6 billion worth of damage, one can only expect things to get much worse. Global temperatures reached an exceptional high in 2023, making it the warmest year on record. Average land and ocean surface temperatures in 2023 was 2.12 degrees Fahrenheit above the 20th century average, the highest global temperature since 1850. According to the NOAA, there is a 99% chance that 2024 will rank among the top five warmest years. December 2023 was the warmest December on record. For the ninth consecutive month, so was the global ocean surface temperature. Our broken, dysfunctional relationship with nature has caused wildlife populations to plummet by 69% since 1970. California has seen a 20% decline in native species, and over 600 species are at risk of extinction. More than 1 million acres of natural area have been lost to human encroachment in the last 20 years only. The state has lost over 90% of its coastal and inland wetlands, 99% of its riparian areas, and most of its native grasslands. Without protection, these ecosystems will crumble in our hands. Excessive farming and droughts have made the state subject to substantial loss of habitable land, paving the way for desertification. 1.3 million square feet of land are lost per year as a result. Who's to blame? The biggest polluters in the US and the rest of the world are power plants, petroleum refineries, and petrochemical processing plants. And what can we do? At times like these, all hope seems lost. We have become the bane of our own collective existence. Our hands and voices now hold the power to speak and rise up for change. We have decisions to make that sway our future in light of accumulated mistakes of our past. Do our arms lie with those concerned with the betterment of our children's future, or with those who care for personal gain? The earth cries and retaliates in wake of our destruction. With or without us, she shall heal. The question remains, will we?